Hey everyone, this is Yash, and welcome to my untitled series of small suggestions, tips, improvements for Rustlang to help you with your workflow. I want to do a bit of a shorter form factor video, mostly for me to like learn how to edit videos and maybe start doing longer videos, but also to, you know, give you just like a 2-minute overview of something you might not otherwise have learned about that can improve and help with your workflow. Today's video, what we'll be covering is a nice little utility called Debug Struct. So one way to debug things in Rust is by printing things to the command line. The way you would do that is you do a call to print line or debug, which in this case is ideal, and you give it a variable. So in this case, let's initialize an instance of foo and try and print it like that. And then we can pass to foo. And if we run this, it gives us an error. It says, hey, you need to implement debug. Now, most of the time, it's really straightforward. You simply say derive debug, and then we're good. Now we can run this. We say run. And then out pops this, foo equals foo. And here on the right-hand side, in the bottom right corner, you can see a struct foo with two fields, bar and baz. Now, say we had, we're not able to derive. A reason why you may not be able to derive is, for example, if a type, an inner field, cannot be derived. A common example of this is, say you're wrapping over a closure. So say, let's create a type which cannot be, does not implement debug, struct baz, right? This does not implement debug. And we take it as a parameter here, and then we initialize it here. And this will say, hey, baz does not implement debug. Uh-oh, so what do we do here, right? We still want to be able to debug foo, but this type does not implement debug, and we cannot make it such. So instead of doing derive, we now need to create a custom implementation. And we can do this by going into the suggestion here, say convert to manual impl format debug for foo, which gives us this implementation here. And now we can start to fill this out. Right, now we can say write f the name of the struct. So this is the longhand version where we like give it the name of the struct and we say, hey, is this called foo? Like that. Like that. And then we would like go over to fields and we would maybe like try and add a squiggly here, just so we can get this like struct-like output, right? But that doesn't necessarily compose too great. And it's very tedious. So instead, what we can do is use something called structured formatting helpers. F dot debug struct. Here we give it a name, foo dot field, and then we give it a name and a value. So in this case, we say bar, and then we say self dot bar. And then here, and then we call finish at the end of it. This works much more efficiently. Now, if we print this, we get the output and we're missing the field. Now, something that I like to do is for fields which are contained, but we cannot print. In this case, we cannot print baz. We say dot field baz. And then here, baz. Something like this. Oh, we need to borrow this. And then we run this. And then that works. Right? It's contained within. It says here. And then we just give it a little placeholder name. So far, we've only taken a look at debug struct, which is great for debugging named pairs of key values. But what if you want to have an unnamed pair of key values? Or what if you don't have keys and values, but only keys? You might want to look at debug map or debug set. Say you have an array-like structure, maybe debug list is a great fit. Or just a tuple or a tuple struct. Debug tuple is great for that. You can even combine these various types to create more interesting nested structures and create like more compact views, which is great when you're like writing or hand rolling display or debug impls and you want people to easily see relevant information. consider thinking about how you can combine these types and what the right type is for your data. And that's how you go from a automatic derive to a custom debug implementation with very little effort and all formatting preserved. In the future, we might add a addition to Rust Analyzer that can auto-generate the struct, list, all the things. But that's for the future. But for now, thanks so much. And let me know if you found this helpful. Let me know if you'd like to see more of these. Until then, take care.